First of all, let's start with your wonderful performance as producing a quite sensational photograph that earned you some good money from Veuve Clicquot, I understand.
Yeah, it was very pleasing. Down at Lord's last week, they announced the winners of the Veuve Clicquot cricket competition, and they went through a kind of highly commended, and you thought, oh, I don't really want to get highly commended, but and then third, second, for, and it yeah, it turned out that my picture of Ravi Bapara came out top of the pile. So yeah, very pleasing.
And did you get a giant rubbery check?
No, but very nice. Veuve Clicquot and ECB had put the picture in a frame, so I've got my own picture that I took in a frame now. So that doesn't happen very often, and a lovely big bottle of Veuve Clicquot. Which is what was it, 6 litres? I think it's called a Methuselah. Fantastic. So I'm thinking of the best time to crack that open.
I was going to say, you haven't got through it yet, then.
No, not yet. I'm thinking of either a barbecue, or I actually thought, and this isn't, it's a bit of a worrying thought, but I thought, if I saved it till, just say go under a bus or something, and I'm no longer with, it'd be lovely for the wake to have a big bottle of champagne with my name engraved on it. Because everyone goes, oh, yeah, he's gone now. Let's have some champagne.
So from celebrating a wonderful photograph, we've now gone quite morbid, and now we're at your funeral.
A little bit. Well, hopefully it's not in the next couple of weeks, but it'd be quite ironic if it was, wouldn't it?
Would now, yeah. It must be nice to be honoured for your photography. You're obviously well known on the circuit, Phil, and been around a few years. You know, the grey tinges are implying that.
Oh, thanks very much, Barney. I'll have a quick check of your head as well for any grey hairs. But yeah, I've been. I think we were talking about it yesterday in last night in the restaurant. 1987 was my first Test match. I didn't exactly cover myself in glory in that one. Chris Broad at Sydney Cricket Ground got 100. And then he got out, and I thought, oh, he's out now. And as he walked past the stumps, he knocked a couple over, and I missed that picture. So not the best of starts, but I think I've got a couple of pictures since then in the 22 years since that debut.
And you're still enjoying it, which is, of course, the main thing.
Who said that?
Well, you imply you are by the dress sense, certainly, because, yeah. Phil, you're renowned for your shirts, and you've got another one. You're brightening up Durham today.
Well, yeah, I found it in the case and thought this is one from Barbados. It was a special purchase out there. Actually, during the Test match when Ravi Bapara got hit, so this was a kind of Ravi Bapara shirt I'm wearing.
In the West Indies, you put together a small film documenting your time out there. And it's going down. It's quite a cult classic, I understand.
Well, people seem to like it. Getting a few comments. There's a couple of comments that people don't like it. But that's really... hello.
Oh, hello. As if on cue.
It wasn't really planned. We just started making this video, and we thought, oh, well, there's Sir Trevor McDonald. We'll try and have a word with him. Viv Richards, Ian Botham, Nasser Hussain. And so we've got a few stars in it. Kind of behind the scenes, Gareth Copley's help maker. He's a very talented lad. In fact, he's not a very good photographer, so he, as you were saying, I think he should change tack and do more video. Maybe message to the PA people there that Gareth should do more video and less photography. If you type in two beers kidney into the search, you should be able to find it. But yeah, a lot of big stars. I didn't mention the biggest star of it, Tim Abraham. What a superstar that man.
Sky Sports News, of course.
Yeah, he's just fantastic. He's wasted. And there are rumours that he's in talks with... maybe going to Hollywood.
Really?
Yes.
What kind of role?
Well, he's thinking of work. Well, Mel Gibson, his career's in decline. I think he's going to take off where Mel's left it.
Braveheart.
Braveheart 2, yeah, with Tim Abraham.
Now, tell us a little bit about a photographer's day, because a lot of people just think, you know, you go down, you take a few pictures, you have a cup of tea, a bit of banter. I mean, it's a lot more than that, isn't it, Phil?
It's nothing like that, because, for one, I'm not a tea drinker. So there's no tea drinking.
Champagne?
No, I haven't opened it yet. I thought you were listening before.
For the wake, yeah.
it can be a long day if you put in the hours. You've got to get there about kind of 8:30, 9 o'clock at the latest, depending what ground you're at. Put your tripod down. You might get your second camera ready and bolt it to a railing somewhere, and that's controlled by a radio-controlled thingy that sets that off. And then match from... going to be 11 till 6:30 or something, finish up about 7:30. So long hours, kind of a 12-hour day, but, you know, you're sitting out in the sunshine, you're having a bit of banter, chat with your mates, and it's all good, really.
And occasionally you get to meet the Digi Girls or the Empower Girls.
And, well, yeah, there's Empower Girls. There's the Digi Girls did raise the bar a bit in Trinidad. I mean, they were very, very talented dancers, and they had a lot of costume changes, actually, the Digicel Girls.
Maybe that's something you should get involved in.
Changing costume? Yeah, I might do that.
Are there any that really stick in the mind? Photographs or even just memories of cricket?
Yeah. Well, people can look at them if they go to philipbrownphotos.com and go to the... If you've only got a short amount of time, go to the portfolio section, have a look at what I think are kind of some of the best pictures from over the years. I kind of like capturing the kind of offbeat pictures, like, you know, I went to Kandy in 2003 and there were kids in the scoreboard kind of watching through all the holes and that kind of thing. So, yeah, I mean, 2005, as everyone knows, was a hugely memorable series and just fantastic to be there. I was kind of at every day of training and, you know, every day of the matches. So, you know, it was great memories there, even as an Australian, having...
Which you may or may not know.
Yeah. I 20 years in England, you kind of lose your accent a bit, but... Mate, I can put it on a bit.
So the career is on the upward curve, Phil.
Well, you hope so, but then if it's, you know, it's got a peak at some stage.
Could so just take a bad interview and it all goes down.
Yeah. Let's hope it didn't peak at Lord's last week when I picked up the big champagne and now it's in terminal decline.
True, but it was a good moment. Let's hope the funeral doesn't come around too soon.
Let's hope so. I don't really want to get to 90, though, or anything like that. So somewhere between 46 and 90 is fine.
Well, not even 100.
No. Don't want to do... What? Me in a nursing home? That's scary, isn't it?
What are you going to wear, by the way?
What, when I'm 100?
Yeah. No, at your funeral.
I don't think you have any control over what they do.
Well, you can put it in the will, can't you?
Mate, this is getting a really morbid now.
Anyway, Phil Brown, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure. Congratulations on your awards. And I'm sure there'll be many more to come.
Thank you. And everyone... Keep tuning into the ECB website. It's a way forward.